purchase of VSU South Campus property. Ms. Davis.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. This is the next step in the process for you all to move forward with a consideration of purchasing the Valdosta State University continuing ed space that's the former Georgia Power building. In the statutes that are required for the state to liquidate property, there's some extra steps. So one of these involved a posting at the location and also an opportunity for public comment at that location. We had to re-advertise and go through that posting process twice. It was handled by the attorney's office because of Hurricane Helene. But now that has happened. The reason this is before you tonight is because you would be required to consider any of the public feedback that was provided during that meeting on site, if there had been any. But there were no citizens that showed up to weigh into that. So this is on your agenda as a formality this evening. There is no action that is required. We just needed those public comments, if there had been any, to be before you. The attorneys most wisely thought that it was good to go ahead and put it on the agenda so that we had some record of it again coming before you, even though there were no comments to discuss.
So what you're saying, the decision has been made to purchase it?
No, sir. So you will make that decision at your November meeting. We will have everything that is legally required to be prepared in front of you for you all to approve to do that, should you choose to.
I was just going to point out what's really driving this actual requirement is the lease back portion of that. Georgia statute allows the county to lease county property to a public educational institution, but to do that, you must go through the process we're going through of having this public hearing, which was held about 10 days ago. And then having it on your agenda tonight, preliminary to having it on the agenda. It's not the purchase, it's the lease that's requiring this. And that's because of this unique special statute that requires it.
The special amount of revenue that we would be generating on that lease?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Discussion has been initially is that, as most everybody knows, the Board of Election Office has really is outgrown its need, as well as parking and access. We feel like that on the first floor level, primarily there where those offices are, where Georgia Power's primary offices used to be at, that would be an ideal location for the Board of Elections. There is an auditorium downstairs that would be able to be utilized during elections to set up equipment and that sort of stuff. Got great parking, easy in, easy out. So I think it would be a huge asset there. And then certainly there are some other opportunities for the second and third floor levels that we are in the process of looking at those. There may be some needs there from the standpoint of, as you know, the health department is making a move. There may be some needs there for one of the other agencies that's in that operation as well that they might be able to locate here. Those are details based on square footage needs that they're going to be coming up with, that those decisions will be made.
We may
and
have an
planning division.
Yes, sir. That could go and into that auditorium.
The auditorium area would be a great location for the planning division.
We hope that this will be a net utility spend to the good. The current services that the chairman is referring to, we believe that they will be moving out of other buildings over the next 2 to 3 years, and then we will be able to liquidate those buildings and decrease our overall footprint. For instance, whenever we built the HR building and DFACS moved into that, their square footage need was 26,000 square feet. The most recent study by the state, they only need 18,000 square feet. So we are trying to be as efficient as we possibly can, keeping in mind our overhead spend and utility spend as it relates to those facilities. So I believe that, to your point, Commissioner Ornstein, once all of those pieces move around, this building will be filled up rather quickly, and also we will be in a much more efficient environment than we currently are.
But the biggest need right now is addressing is the driving is the board of elections. That's really some dated features in it, but at the end of the day, it's a well-constructed, well-built building.
And keep in mind that we can only pay the appraised value as a local government for a building. So the fact that the Board of Regents and VSU were willing to lobby so hard on our behalf for this action to happen at the appraised value, we're very grateful for that. Dr. Calverhall, Tracy Martin, and his team really worked very hard for us there, and it was primarily because I think we all believe very strongly in the relocation of the Board of Elections to that area, needing additional parking there, an easy way for people who have trouble walking long distances, being able to get right into the building and do their business there, and it being right at the center of the community. It was, those were all good things.
Ironically, the Board of Elections used to be located right across the street on the opposite corner.
In a postage stamp building.
That's right.
I'm just happy that in the wake of the purchase, that we won't be getting another big, huge renovation bill. I mean, I know we'll have some fit up and stuff to do, but I just don't see a whole lot of renovation costs on the backside of this purchase.
And we agree with that. We felt like that it was really important, that building, and how it would be able to be utilized.
Speaking of that, do we have any idea what to anticipate on getting the building functional for the Board of Elections?
It'll probably take next year to get all my calls down.
We got a year.
Yeah, to get all that done. And we've still got this tenant lease situation. There's someone that will still be in the part of that building for a certain period of time. I think probably until after the first year at some point.
We had originally thought that they would need it for probably through the first quarter because the space that the university has them moving into was being renovated. But now we've been told that that area sustained some damage from Helene, so it may be mid-year before the university has moved. But in walking through and understanding the current workflows of Board of Elections, I don't think that we're in an environment where we're going to have to go in and move walls. I think this is more of a cleaning and some paint and just moving into that space.
And all that's going to be done before we complete it, before we take over.
No, sir, that will be done before the Board of Elections moves in. We'll be taking the building as is currently, and then we'll have to wait for those university services to move out, and then we'll go in and clean and paint and then move Board of Elections
we'll
in.
Do that. That's all right.
Yes. One thing related to that is, I think, of concern as Helene has taken out a lot of our fiber and connectivity. One of the things that IT worked very, very hard on from the minute the winds calmed enough until about last week was restoring all of that fiber. So as you all know, it is a data center close to here that connects the Board of Elections to our systems. And all of that's very important as far as the uploading of data and all of that during the election process. So that fiber was impacted in 13 places from here to the Board of Elections due to Helene. So I'm going to mention in my report where we are with our facility damage and our estimates there. But we are going underground with that fiber whenever we restore it. We think there'll still be some future need possibly for the old Board of Elections location. That will be determined by you all, and we'll talk about that probably at our spring retreat. But we're going to go ahead and bury that fiber from here to that continuing ed building, and then from there to the Board of Elections. So we have that continuity, and if we do get wins again, we're not putting it back on the pole once more.
Well, I'm proud of you for having foresight to see this, and your relationship with Tracy, or however all this came about. So like that we have an opportunity that, you know, had you not had a good relationship, that we might not have had the opportunity for this.
Is our Board of Elections staff going to increase when they get set up in this nice place?
I don't know that. That's up to them. They're wrong.
They're on our budget.
I wish the Sheriff's Department. That was my
Well, the Sheriff's Department's different. You know that. And we don't treat everybody the same.
All right, any other questions on that agenda item? Of course, there's no action to be taken. Just if you have any questions, then we'll move on. County Manager, report.